Hello for Thursday, February 10th. This is the Dow Daily Chart. And we have here the 161% Fibonacci projection based on the high from the spring down to the low in the summer, and then the 100% retrace back up to the top there, and then the 161. But when we showed this chart before, I guess when we saved it, this bottom line here, the zero line had actually moved up. So this line was then moved down, and it showed at 12,250. Actually, we're showing it here 12,267. Now, as we're showing it, it's not perfect because we have a low of 96.20 when actually the low is 96.14, but it's very difficult to put these lines exactly where you want them. Anyway, we came pretty close to this area, going up to 12,254 for the high. So maybe it'll make one more run into this area. Obviously, it could break out above it, but it's close enough. This is showing some resistance, and maybe it'll get to it even more resistant. But just pointing out there was a slight change there. But if you look at a shorter time frame chart, the 60-minute chart, when it did pull back, it ran right into this trend line, and it bounced squarely right there and moved back up. So far, it was up for the day a little bit, so it could continue. But watch this trend line. A break there would probably could very easily bring it down to the 12,150 area, which is the lower Bollinger Band. We'd watch that for possible support as well. And on the 5-minute chart, you can see the action as it dropped to this lower trend line and moved back up, and then out of this trading channel it's been in, actually moved outside of that. And you can see, of course, that the Williams indicator called for a little bounce there, as it didn't call for it. It told you could go ahead and buy that bounce as it crossed back over this 80 line moving back up. We talked in the newsletter about the interest rates continuing to climb higher, and showed this TNX, the 10-year note yield chart. And right now it closed for the day at 3.64%. Now, long term could go back up to 4%, and this measured move takes it to around 3.8%. But we do have on the chart this negative divergence on the RSI. So know that this could correct. In the past, even though this was a horizontal breakout here, note that in November, when it did go up into some resistance, but eventually it did pull back all the way from the retested the whole move up and came down actually twice and came down to that breakout line. So this also, before it even reached the top, and it may get up here to measured move, but it could at any time also pull back. Now, if rates happen to go down, that means bonds will become more interesting. People go into bonds and maybe come out of stocks as bond prices change. So that would create some pullback in the market if that happens. So that's why people paying attention to bonds, or the inverse, which would then be the rates themselves. Now, the SPX lost the ground for the day, closing down a little over 3 points. And here we're looking at a 5-minute chart. So we do have the same channel like in the Dow. The difference being is we broke out below this trend line, and that's not an encouraging thing. And so if it stays below that, then this still remains negative. At the same time, whenever you look at this formation, it's always a possibility that it's a bull flag. So if it stays within this, it can be a positive as well. But it is a negative that broke through the other channel. And we do have some support at this 1308, which you remember from the past was resistance that it had hit on once and twice and then finally broke out on the third time. So on a pullback, that is a possible area to watch for support. And I think we have actually another, this is just a long term, it's just a repeat, that longer term we may get up to that 1344 area, and this shows that we're back down underneath or right at that line. And on the Russell, similar situation so far as the way it looks in this downward sloping channel. It did lose ground, and it is below as well. It's the wedge that it was in, and so that's not a positive thing. That is a negative. And here's the, doesn't show you very much, SML, small caps, or the mid caps. And the mid caps did pull back, as we expected, that after 2 days running above the top Bollinger Band, they need to do it. And so it depends on if that picks up speed. But note, the volume was stronger on Wednesday than it was on Tuesday's up day. So this may continue. If that continues, then the market is coming down. Silver also corrected a bit during the day, an indecisive candle, but it could, as it ran up the Bollinger Band, it could be in for a little bigger correction possibility there. The weekly gold doesn't really show us either anything, and GDX just pulled back a little bit, but it's not noticeable on that time frame chart. Okay, so let's take a look at the additions to the watch list. First, a couple things that we did have some things trigger. A couple, we had two stocks that did like WWWW, and what's the other one that gapped up in the morning and ran nicely, but were had gapped up, and you could only use the 15-minute rule, or that'd be one method of trading them. Anyway, now occasionally what we'll have is ones like BKI, which did, we had double sets of triggers. We do have this clear up to 2770. We have this the last time it created a wick, though that's a possibility. So this did move up above the 2675. It didn't run up very much, about to 2670. Where's the high? 2718. So it took 35, 40 cents or so. And then did pull back, but it still looks good. It's just lower volume down here, that's all. But if it stays below the low of the day, if you're in the trade, you could probably hold. Otherwise, maybe you wanted to exit it if you didn't exit it, and then re-enter if the next time it moves above. That's one possible way. CBOE. Remember, when they move really, really strong, don't ever be shy to take some profits, and this one did. It broke out and then moved really strongly from the 2446 all up above 2750. So when you get 3 points in a move like that, it's very nice. And of course, it gave up a lot of those points during the day. We did mention that it was gone up and it started losing, so, but it had great volume, and it may be one to watch. It may continue once again from this level, more may pull back and move up some more. Also, the price line also was up higher than it did. I think it was up 14 points at one point during the day, so this was another a very nice move. So now let's take a look at some additions to the watch list. We've got NFG over 71 42. It has pulled back a couple days, but note the volume is lower. It's below the 60-day average, so it may continue a pullback. The other approach on these, if it holds a 20-day and the market is improving, and this starts reversing, watch for those for reversals if you like to trade reversals as well. Sometimes they can work out. And of course, the main idea is that you know your stop point. If you're buying like at the 20-day and then it reverses and goes back under it, then you get out of it and keep your losses very small. NEI is a possibility. Had good volume, 2 million shares, which is normally over 300% of its normal volume, over about $2.30 would be the top line, and somewhere in between, if it gets a pullback, could be a possibility also. Then KSU, 52.50 looks like a possible area here, or 52.72. So the line we have at 52.50, but note that 52.72 is the high that it was recently. So you take your pick, but it had increased volume, which is typically a good sign. HNR is next, over 1293 or 1354. It's another one like CBOE that gave up a bunch of its gains, but it had very good volume. It looks like this could continue, and it's just when you look at it, everyone that sees it thinks, oh boy, this could go up and test that December high of 14. So it's worth a trade, because at 13, that's a good dollar profit. Now, whether it's going to do it or not is a different story, but this is the possibility. So if it pulls back, and it could, because it's been up 2 days in a row. And look, the last time it made a big move up from the low in January, it came up and then pulled back a couple days and ran up again. So that could happen. That'd be a better probably scenario if that did, and then you could pick some up on a pullback. Sometimes that's good to also to do partial buys at one point and then add buys at a different point. OCZ over $8.76, possibility as well. We try and find ones that have good volume, and of course this one also had very good volume, 2 million shares, which is over 200% of its normal. MCZ, Mad Cats Interactive, and occasionally this one's an interesting trade, and since it's recovered so well, it had this good pullback, and it had done so before, you know, and then it gapped up, Then it pulled back quite a bit, but it's run back up into it on good increasing volume. And so if it can move over that 126, that's a possibility trade as well. And just watch, because it's already above the top Bollinger Bands. And this can run up above it for a while, but it may be a single day trade at first, depending on the volume, and then wait for a little bit of a pullback. So those are the normal ones. We have another one that we're not putting on the watch list because it is such a low price stock, but we just happen to notice it by accident. And we said, wait a minute, this isn't so interesting. It's kind of interesting in that it's running, it's a TIV, and it's run right into its 50-day. But since it had increased volume, it's a possibility it breaks above this. And its high for the day was, what, 47 cents. And if it could, and you can see it had resistance about 46. So if it can break above that, 47 cents is the 50-day. If it can break above it, sometimes these can go a good percentage move. And when we look back over here, at one point it ran up, you know, it was clear above its 200-day, which is almost a double from that point. So anyway, if you'd like to trade the real cheap penny stocks, that is a possibility. So that's what we have for this Thursday. We hope you have a great day trading. And we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas, and check out the tweets during the day. So thanks a lot. See you soon. Bye.